We're going to move to the coolest technology company in the world today. How many of you have an Apple product? How many of it? No, put your show of hands or just show it. Let's see how many. Okay, yeah, I'd say it's probably about 90%. Probably about 90% in here and who's connecting remotely has an Apple product. Well, Apple is an amazing example of the third theme of today, and that is prioritization. Apple gets it. It's simplicity in action. So let's look together at this amazing Apple story. So Da Vinci said, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Isn't that so true, right? It's about simplifying. They do a great job. So let's kick this off. In 1976, two guys named Steve Wozniak, and Steve Jobs set out to change the world. But they called it something different. Their vision was to make a dent in the universe. But it wasn't using computers or the mainframes at the time. They had a new innovative idea, and that idea was personal computers or PCs. So they created a business called Apple Computer. All of their Apples and iterations of Apples were big successes, which caused a little company called IBM to create really the first PC and take over that market, which caused Apple to really think about what they stood for and who they were, and they did so brilliantly by launching the first Apple Macintosh in 1984 and this groundbreaking TV ad.
Today we celebrate the first glorious anniversary of the information purification collectives.
Apple Computer will introduce Macintosh, and you'll see why 1984 won't be like 1984.
So if you're a little bit younger, just Google 1984 George Orwell, you'll get that commercial. So at a time when computers were incomprehensible, Apple Macintosh was simple. It was graphical. It was easy to use. It was completely innovative and completely different from anything else at the time. Well, that was 1984. Today is 2014, and what makes Apple the most valued and most revered brand in the world today? It's worth more than anything else? Well, the answer is simple. Literally, simplicity is the key to their success and prioritization. Have a look at these advertisements, and you'll see simplicity in action.
And I'm a PC.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
And I'm a PC.
sells organic mushrooms from Arizona.
This organic market looks pretty close to you.
How many ounces in a cup?
This might answer your question.
Well, I knew that.
Amazing, huh? Millions of words have been written about Apple and Steve Jobs. It's amazing, isn't it? But everything we really need to know about Apple was in those preceding 90 seconds of clips. It's unbelievable. So what can we learn at Nestle from Apple? I mean, they're not just a technology company. They're a technology lovers company. And they always work from the customer point of view and work backwards and think about how do we simplify here. Also, they completely stand for innovation. Think different. They live by the adage of never say never. And they are totally consumed with prioritization and focus on what they do. They don't make a ton of things, they make a few things and market them exceptionally well. Steve Jobs loved this next quote. Henry Ford said, "If I'd asked my customers what they wanted, they would have said a faster horse." Apple is always anticipating consumer and customer trends, and they know the best way to predict the future is to create it. In 1976, Steve and Steve set out to make a dent in the universe. Well, they've taken a big Apple bite out of it, haven't they? Now, I'm going to show you one last clip, and as you're watching this clip, and if this was made by Nestle Canada and sent out to a promise to the world or the rest of the country, what would this say, and what would you do better differently tomorrow?
Here's to the crazy ones. The misfits. The rebels. The troublemakers. The round pegs in the square holes. The ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them. Because they change things. They push the human race forward. And while some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
Incredible Apple. So for the intellect side or the business side, so Apple is the most valued brand in the world today. It depends, it goes up and down. It's right now at about $485 billion. So Google is catching up, but Apple is the most valued brand in the world today. Think different. I think we can learn a lot of things about that and also how they prioritize. So